Okay. Till now we are talking about void charges. But what will be the situation if we are going to talk about volume charge density? In volume charge density, we say that we don't have just single charge. We have distribution of charges. And this distribution is distributed along a volume. So instead of talking about the value of the charge at a specific point, we are talking about the charge density in this volume. So we denote volume charge density by unit or by symbol rho v, and its unit is coulombs per meter cube. Assuming that we have incremental volume delta v, so the limit of delta q over delta v when delta v tends to zero corresponds to this volume charge density. So rho v is the limit when the volume tends to zero of delta q over delta v. So the small amount of charge delta q, the small amount delta v is delta q. So delta q equal rho v delta v. Okay. In other words, if I have volume charge density in a specific volume, so the total charge inside this volume, it can be represented as the integration over this volume, rho v dv, where rho v is the volume charge density and dv is the integration with respect to the volume. Okay? Now, assuming that we are talking about incremental charge in a volume charge density, so the electric field of an incremental charge located at the point r dash, the electric field at the point r due to an incremental charge located at r dash, it can be found out by using the rule of the electric field of a point charge, which is already obtained from Coulomb's law. So it is delta q over 4 by epsilon, the modulus of r minus r dash squared, multiplied by the unit vector in the direction of r minus r dash. So r minus r dash over the modulus of r minus r dash. Or in other words, it is delta q is rho v delta v, and r minus r dash squared multiplied by r minus r dash, this is r squared or r cube. So it is rho v delta v over 4 by epsilon r minus r dash squared multiplied by r minus r dash over r minus r dash as well. Okay, so this is the incremental electric field due to incremental charge, and this incremental charge is due to incremental charge volume in a specific incremental volume. So if I'm talking about the total electric field, it would be the summation, or in other words, the integration with respect to the volume. And the volume here effectively is represented in the coordinates dash, so it would be dv dash. So in this case, the electric field, the total electric field, would be the volume integration of rho v as a function of r dash, dv dash, where v dash here is x dash, y dash, z dash, over 4 by epsilon naught r minus r dash squared multiplied by the unit vector in the direction of r minus r dash. Effectively, this volume integration can be simplified for the case of surface charge density by integration over surface, and for the case of linear charge density by integration of a line. So we will see other simpler forms from this volume integration. As an example, we are going to study the electric field due to the line charge density. Assuming that we have line charge density along the z-axis, and this line charge density has charge density rho L, and we have abbreviated as a L because it is linear, not volume. So it is Coulomb per meter. Now it is required to find out the total electric field at the point P away from the infinite line charge. This infinite line charge is extending across the z-axis from minus infinity to infinity. So to obtain the electric field, we start with incremental length delta L, and this incremental length will include incremental charge delta Q. This incremental charge delta Q is actually the line charge density rho L multiplied by the incremental length delta Z dash. And we are going to assume the coordinates of this incremental point. Effectively, it is along the z-axis, so its x and y are 0 and 0. And its value of z is z dash. So, this is the location of the source point. The location of the observation point would be assumed to be r in y direction. Doesn't matter in x or y, or doesn't matter, but we will assume it is r in y direction, and 0 in x direction, and 0 in z direction. So this is the location of the observation point. Now, assuming that this incremental charge, and this is the observation point, so the electric field due to this incremental charge would be delta E, and it is in the direction from the point of charge to the observation point. So it is in the direction AR, where AR here is the unit vector from the point R minus R dash. Okay? Okay, so the electric field would be delta Q, which is rho L delta Z dash, over 4 by epsilon naught, the modulus of R minus R dash cube, multiplied by the value of R minus R dash. So, this is the incremental electric field due to incremental length along this infinite line of charge. So, to obtain the total electric field, it is required to integrate this electric field along the z dash axis from minus infinity to infinity. Okay? Alright. The value of R, the observation point, is y in y direction, or in other words, rho in rho direction if I'm talking about cylindrical coordinates. And effectively, this problem is more suitable to be presented in cylindrical coordinates because we have cylindrical symmetry around the infinite line charge. This infinite line charge, it can represent the axis of an infinite cylinder of radius r or radius rho. Okay. And r dash here is z dash in z direction. So r minus r dash would be rho in direction rho minus z dash in direction z. The amplitude here would be the square root of rho squared plus z squared. So by applying the amplitude, it is rho squared plus z dash squared, square root, so 1 over 2. This actually to the power 3, so r minus r dash to the power 3 is rho squared plus z dash squared, but to the power 3 over 2. 4 by epsilon naught is 4 by epsilon naught, rho L z dz dash, and here rho r minus r dash is rho in direction rho minus z dash in direction z. Okay? Now, before going more in calculation, let us see an important property of this structure. Here we have an incremental length delta z dash located at the point z dash. And because the line charge is extending from minus infinity to infinity, there is another similar one at minus z dash. And the other one in minus z dash will introduce an electric field in this direction. So the electric field in this direction, if we analyzed it into rho component and z component, we can note that the electric field from the point in the negative z has z component of the electric field in positive z direction, while the incremental length in positive z direction has electric component Ez in negative z direction. And because they have the same distance and the same value, this dEz in the negative direction would equal dEz in the positive direction. So by integration from minus infinity to infinity, each z component coming from the negative part would cancel the corresponding z component from the positive part. So the total electric field in z direction is expected to be zero. So without doing any integration, I'm expecting that the integration with respect to z dash would be zero, or the z component would be zero. This is from a physical point of view. From mathematical point of view, we can see it in another point. The integration with respect to z dash, z here, it's coming from negative to positive, so z is odd, and z squared is even. So the value of z over rho squared plus z squared to the power 3 over 2 is odd function, and the integration from minus z to z would be zero. So this is from mathematical point of view, because of the function is odd, its integration from negative value to the same positive value would be zero. From physical point of view, the electric field in the z direction from the upper half will cancel the electric field in the z direction from the lower half. So in all cases, there is no electric field in z direction. On the other hand, the rho component from the upper half will add to the rho component from the lower half. So it would be double. So instead of going the integration from minus infinity to infinity, we can say that this integration of from 0 to infinity and multiply it by 2. So there will be only rho component, and we can do the integration from 0 to infinity and just multiply this integration with 2. So effectively, the total electric field which we are expecting is in rho direction, and it is the integration of this value from minus infinity to infinity, or from 0 to infinity multiplied by 2. Okay, let us do this. Is that what I'm saying? Here the incremental electric field due to the incremental length. We have only the rho component, so the incremental electric field in rho component would be this part only, which is rho L multiplied by rho dz dash. And you should differentiate between rho L, which is the line charge density, and rho, which is the dimension in cylindrical coordinates in rho direction, dz dash over 4 by epsilon rho squared plus z dash squared to the power 3 over 2. By going to this integration with respect to z dash, effectively rho L and rho are constant with respect to z dash, and 4 by epsilon is constant. So this 1 over rho dash rho squared plus z dash squared to the power 3 over 2. By doing this integration, we can obtain this integration in a closed form, as follows. So is rho L over 2 by epsilon naught rho. No one says that this rho can be cancelled with this rho. Rho L is the line charge density. Rho is the distance from the line charge to the observation point, or the normal distance from the point of charge to the observation point. Okay? So here is the electric field due to the infinite line charge density. And it can be noted that the electric field in this case is inversely proportional to the distance from the line charge to the observation point. If we remember, the electric field from point of charge, it was inversely proportional to the square of the distance, 1 over r squared. Here it is 1 over rho only. And its direction in rho direction, where rho is the normal direction on the z-axis, or the normal direction on the line charge. So the electric field normal to the line charge, and its value is inversely proportional to the distance, or to the normal distance from the line charge. Okay? And it should be also noted that the electric field here is independent on z. So regardless what is the observation point, the location of the observation point in the z is the same value. Okay? As a generalization for the rule that we have driven for infinite line charge along the z-axis, we can assume that if the line charge is not along the z-axis, but is parallel to the z-axis, and it is centered at a position x naught and y naught. So in this case, the normal distance from the line charge to the observation point is the value of the x of the observation point minus x of the line charge in x direction plus the value of y of the observation point minus the y of the line charge in the y direction. So in this case, the value of rho will be replaced by x minus x dash squared plus y minus y dash squared. So in this case, we say that the electric field is rho L, the line charge density, over 2 by epsilon over rho. But rho in this case, as we mentioned, is x minus x dash squared plus y minus y dash squared. And this would be in the direction AR, where AR is a unit vector coming from the line charge to the observation point. So it is x minus 6 in x direction, y minus 8 in z direction, in y direction, over the magnitude of this vector. So this is a unit vector AR from the line charge to the observation point. It should be noted here, since the line charge is parallel to the z-axis, we are talking about the value of x and y. Now, assuming that the line is parallel to the x-axis, so we are going to talk about the value of z and y. If the line charge is parallel to the y-axis, we are going to talk about the value of x and z. I hope that this is clear. Okay? Alright. So, the electric field in this case, if I have infinite line charge located at the point x equal 6 and y equal 8, so the electric field would be rho L over 2 by epsilon multiplied by the unit vector x of the observation point minus 6, the source point in x direction, y minus 8 in y direction, over rho squared. So rho squared, because we have rho here in the unit vector. So rho here, x minus 6 squared plus y minus 8 squared. Okay?